Hey everyone, Jason here, digital marketing consultant, and in this email autoresponder review and showdown, we're going to be looking at Mailchimp and ConvertKit, specifically three reasons why you should jump ship on Mailchimp and sign up with ConvertKit. Go ahead and make sure you check out the links in the description to other in-depth reviews of both of these softwares so you can figure out which one is best for you. And when you stick around to the end, I'll be sharing my personal migration plan so you can easily switch from Mailchimp to ConvertKit if it winds up being a good solution for your business, but we'll get to that in a second at the end of the video. So, kicking things off, the first thing we need to understand is how Mailchimp and ConvertKit handles your list, and then we can get into those three things. So, very quickly, Mailchimp is a list-based email autoresponder. What this means is that the primary way to segment different people is creating individual lists. Whereas with ConvertKit, you're pretty much just gonna have one master list, and then you're gonna be able to add segmentations and tags on top of everyone on that master list. Now, there's a lot of debate as to which one is better, but this is gonna help you understand why I think ConvertKit wins when it comes to segmentation and tagging of your list, because ConvertKit is one master list and then it just has tags and segmentations. The advantage of doing something like this is it's very easy to stay organized with all of your subscribers, the individual products they've purchased or the individual lead magnets they've downloaded. It's very simple and straightforward to add and remove tags inside of ConvertKit, whereas in Mailchimp, it's a lot more cumbersome. You still have the ability to have tags and segmentation, but you're pretty much siloing all of your different subscribers into individualized lists, which makes it a little harder when you're going to add a little bit of advanced automation, making sure that someone isn't receiving three different sequences at once. Whereas in ConvertKit, it's a lot easier to see how tags are overlapping, and it's very easy to make sure if someone has a tag or they're in a particular segment, they're not going to get specific sequences or email messages. So it's just a very great way to make sure that your buyers aren't getting coupon codes for something they've already bought. Which leads me into reason number two, ConvertKit is awesome compared to Mailchimp, and that deals with the automations. At the end of the day, it's not good enough anymore to just send out emails to everyone on your list. We need to send personalized emails to each person on our list based upon the past actions they've taken, products they've purchased, lead magnets they've opted in for, you know, links they've clicked, blog posts they've actually read. And when it comes to creating automations, creating sequences, ConvertKit comes out on top. Now, I do want to add the asterisk that Mailchimp does allow you to create segment and tag-based automations as well. What comes down to is usability, because with ConvertKit, it's very easy. It's a drag and drop interface. You can see a graphical representation of how tags are being added and removed and when people are buying something or when they're going into a particular sequence. Whereas with Mailchimp, you're going to still need to do all of that, but on paper or in some other program, because with Mailchimp, the way they handle their automations, it doesn't have that nice visual representation like you get with ConvertKit or an ActiveCampaign or Drip. Now, reason number three, ConvertKit comes out on top when it comes to creating your advanced automations for your email subscribers, is the price. Now, what's awesome about Mailchimp is that it's free for up to 2,000 subscribers or a certain number of emails per month, which is why a lot of people gravitate towards it in the beginning, which is also something I recommend. However, as soon as you start paying, it's a very different story. So as soon as you hit that 2,000 subscriber mark, you're going to be looking at $30 a month with Mailchimp or $49 a month with ConvertKit. And when you get up to 5,000 subscribers, you're going to be looking at $50 a month for Mailchimp and $49 a month for ConvertKit. So between 2,000 and 5,000 subscribers, ConvertKit is only going to be an extra $5 to $10 a month, depending upon how many subscribers you have. ConvertKit is a lot more block pricing, whereas Mailchimp, the price will change pretty much every 500 or 200 some odd subscribers. So what's very important here to realize is that you're going to only be paying $5 to $10 a month more for all of the awesome automations ConvertKit gives you. So while it is still a little bit more expensive than Mailchimp, all the extra features you're going to be getting is well worth the price. Now, if you get to the 5,000 subscriber mark, this is where Mailchimp really becomes dirt cheap compared to a lot of the other solutions out there, because the monthly price of ConvertKit jumps up to $79 a month as soon as you cross that 5,000 subscriber mark. However, once you're at 5,000 subscribers, MailChimp isn't what we should be comparing ConvertKit to, because chances are once you've reached 5,000, you should be making a decent income from your list, and you should start comparing ConvertKit to things like Drip, which would be $100 a month, and ActiveCampaign, which would be $135 a month at the 5,000 subscriber count. So what's really cool here is all along the way, when you're first getting started, you can use MailChimp. And this is comes into where my pro tip comes in. This is what I recommend you do looking at all of these solutions. So if you're already using MailChimp, great. If you're figuring out which one to use, then start with MailChimp because nothing beats free. And as you grow your email list, as you get up to around that 1,500 subscriber mark, you're going to want to turn over to ConvertKit because you're going to have to gradually move all of your subscribers out of MailChimp into ConvertKit so that you can begin to enjoy the benefits of all of the advanced automations and sequencing and tagging that ConvertKit offers you. Below 15,000 subscribers, it doesn't make a lot of sense to have all of those features. It's just kind of overkill for such a small list. So what's really cool is you can start migrating over, and I recommend starting from the back of your funnel to the front. So that means when you sign up for ConvertKit, and you're around 1,500 subscribers with MailChimp, then you're going to want to migrate over your customer lists and people who've already bought from you, right? So you want to start with your smallest list and then go down the line all the way until you get to the list of people who are opting into your email list for the very first time. And what's really cool about doing it this way is you make sure you give yourself enough time to figure out how ConvertKit works. It's really only going to take you an afternoon, and redo all of the sequencing and automation you put inside of MailChimp, and then of course go above and beyond what you've done in MailChimp. And this way you make sure that no one is moved over halfway through an email sequence, which is something that a lot of my clients have run into, where we're trying to upgrade them to something, but they're still inside MailChimp and they have, you know, 500 or 600 people going through a sequence. So you want to make sure that everybody goes through the sequence inside of MailChimp before you migrate them over to ConvertKit, just so people don't get emails twice or they don't get the wrong discount emails if that's something that you're doing. So I hope you found this video actionable and informative. If you did, go ahead and hit that like button and subscribe for more digital marketing reviews and demos just like the one in this video over on my channel. I'm going through the entire process of what it takes to be successful with your digital marketing. And of course, figuring out your autoresponder is a pretty important part of making sure you grow your business and list the right way. So go ahead and comment below if you have any questions, hit that like button, subscribe, and as always, keep building the business you love.